What happened? We now called the arts master, Mr. Ahmed. He now said, Sly, Sylvester Oromoni Jr. said, he fell while playing football. Yeah, are you sure? So when the boy went to the school to pick him that Tuesday, the boy said, this one is beyond four. That the whole body, if he even want to carry him, he couldn't move. If he want to carry him, anywhere he touch, he'll be shouting. And he will open his mouth, put his hand here. Then what happened? The mouth here started having sign of peeling. You know, like when fire burns somebody, immediately it will not peel to that red color, whatever. It will look dark first. Then finally, it will now peel up. That was the beginning. In the night, nobody will sleep. You have to carry it to toilet. If you want to wee, you carry it. Anything, then you will turn in. You'll be telling you, press here, press my chest, my throat. Somebody will say, hey, my back, turn my leg. Wait, oh, carry the legs much more. It will be shouting. Every part of his body. The school said, you have fracture in your leg. This fracture in your leg now turn to every part of your, including your mouth, inside your tongue, your throat. Okay. He told us that he didn't play ball. He didn't go to any field. That he was in his room with his mates, sleeping on his bed in the evening, but he didn't give us the time. But he said it was in the night. These boys walked into that hostel, the junior students hostel.
It's the same hostel, just their room.
It's not their room, separate room.
Yes.
They walked into their room, they put off the lights. He was lying on his bed. They started beating him. With belt, oh. They beat him, then he fell from his bed. They started mashing it with a leg. So that all these places that are painted in is as a result of those mash bruises. He said, nobody, he did not play ball with anybody. Then at the end, they gave him something to drink. He did not know what they gave to him to drink. According to him, they said, they tell all the rest people, maybe whether they send them out or they gather them in one place, that we do not act. He said, if we not talk, we'll kill all of them. If they ask you, tell even the school people, say you were playing ball, say you fall. They threaten them. So the children say, hey, we will not talk. So up till this time, it's because of that threat that made him not to say this thing until that Monday.